Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are having a great day. I read your comments, and so today the girl is complying. What am I complying about? Nadia, when did you get upgraded? So pretty much just keeping things super simple and to the point. The areas of focus for me with the upgrades was really the kitchen and the master bathroom. So let's just kind of go through and through. I ended up doing the plus package, and the plus package was just certain areas of the house to have the wainscoting and also the crown molding. I did decide to delete it out of the formal dining, the wainscoting and also the crown molding, just because it's gonna be my office and I wanted to have a little bit more freedom with what I was gonna do in the space. And also deleted the crown molding in the hallway area because they were doing a 3-inch and what I want to do is do a 4-inch. So I went on ahead and I had them just deleted out. The one thing you don't want to do is pay for a change order. And in a million years, I didn't think that I would ever pay for a change order. But I did. My model was not up. And I did not see the island. I think I had that talk with you guys. And in order for me to change the island, I had to pay for a change order, which I did. And now I have a seven feet long island. Each end of the island has a 12-inch deep flank cabinet. And I really needed that because the kitchen itself just isn't that big. So the cabinets in there are really limited. And you guys know, like, I cook. Like, I don't for fake cook. I like for real cook. And I just really needed that. I paid for the electrical outlet. I also paid for the fireplace in the bookends to go on there. I also upgraded the countertops. The granite that they had just wasn't something that I liked. So I went with something that was just a little bit of a smokier feel. It almost mimics the sandstorm from in the pantry, but just not as opaque. As that, but it has that really nice kind of veining in it, not like anything like a marble or quartz. I also paid for the pan to go into the shower. I also paid extra for the kitchen backsplash. I did the herringbone pattern on that. Instead of doing, I don't know what the original square feet was for the concrete in the back, but I did upgrade it to a 15 by 15 square feet for the back patio. What I did not pay for was to have that little small roof added on somewhere in the future, God willing. Maybe I'll get it sponsored, you know what I'm saying? I don't have to pay for it, but yeah, I didn't do that just because it was really, really crazy how much they were charging for it. I'm not saying that they were wrong for it. I could not afford it. So with the bathroom package, what I paid for was a 12 by 12 niche with a deco for the back tile. And then I also did the what else did I do? I also did the tile around the shower and the tub surround. Did that. I did not upgrade the shower door to a frameless because that wasn't really something they talked to me about, and I wasn't even thinking about the shower door. I didn't think about the shower door until after I signed the contract. Then I was like, dang, I wish I had remembered to do that. So I would say make a list of everything that, like, all your wants. But anyway, by the time I did all the kitchen and bathroom, I probably couldn't still even have gotten it. So let me not even say that. The cabinetry went from a level 1 to a level 3. Level 1, in my personal opinion, it looked as though it was wrapped and then heat sealed, if that makes any sense. Sometimes they do like a wrapping over the cabinets and then they use some heat to kind of seal it so it's not really painted. I want to say when I was flipping through one, I saw one of the cabinets kind of peeling and I was like, the way my kids are set up, let me make sure I get this together. So I did go with the level 3 that looked more like it was like a stain or a finish on it. It still is not wood, I don't think anyway. I did do a 32 by 18 sink. It is an undermount and it's almost like a farmhouse with, you know, but it's not faceless. But it's a really big tub. I felt like because the island was going to be so big and leveled, unlike the previous house, if I didn't get a chance to wash the dishes, I can just pile everything on top, make it look real cute. I am going to be collabing with a Container Store, and I want to look for some stuff for the kitchen, so that's really exciting. The fireplace with the TV entertainment built in, that was also an upgrade. The bookcase, originally I didn't want the bookcase, but I felt like in terms of storage it was going to be the best fit. And then when I started looking at options for how much a credenza was going to cost, it was pretty much the equivalent of the entire bookcase. So in terms of, you know, before or after, I was like, you know what, let's just go ahead and move with it. So I did do that. So with the kitchen upgrade, with everything, I can tell you guys, it added $5,200 onto the price, and that's without the backsplash. What it did was it offered the upgrade appliance package number 2, the stainless gourmet kitchen configuration equals double wall ovens, built-in microwave. Even though the microwave isn't going to be added into the plan, they're leaving it for me upon closing. That way I can still do what I want to do with it. A 30-inch electric smooth cooktop, a vented canopy hood. It says enhanced dishwasher with a French door fridge. The backsplash, instead of it going right underneath the range hood, it actually goes run to the entire top to the ceiling, which was really good. Tile levels 1 through 4, upgrade from standard. Oh, I did do the cabinetry over the washer and dryer in the laundry room. Again, I was under the impression that I was gonna do like a level 3 downstairs and that was it, but they were like, no ma'am, you have to do a level 3 for everything. So they charged me level 3 for every single room in the house. I was like, okay, that's fine. So that was that. The handrail and the threads, that was also an upgrade. The handrail, the threads, the baluster, the first 3 to possibly 6 steps only per plan. And they actually gave me 7 because I was like, I was sitting in the design thing. I was actually sitting for the final signatures on the blueprints, and I was like, listen, please just give me 7 steps, because I felt like I wanted to be able to just see it and just, you know. And they were like, we don't know. I'm like, listen, please, I know what it says, because they kept saying that, oh no, for your plan it's gonna be 3, it's gonna be 3. And I was just like, I don't want to pay extra, please, just. But they did, so I really appreciate that. So I guess I can let the tile go, right? Let it go. I did pay for the plug, like I said, in the pantry, but that's pretty much it. Like my thing is like, it's small, y'all. Like it's real small. That was it. I didn't really do too much. I didn't go too crazy. I felt like in terms of resale, in terms of the property holding its value and stuff, to me this was it. That was that, you know? That was that. God willing, nothing happens, everything goes as planned. What they're projecting is that I get to close possibly the end of January. So I'm really excited about that. Yeah, it's kind of crazy to think that literally in like 2.5 months, like my life has changed anyway, but it hasn't. Well, it's hit me, but it hasn't hit me, you know? But I think once I'm like in my own house, like that's gonna be like, wow, you know? Cause the other day, someone asked me something about my car and I was like, no, I bought my own car. And I was like, oh, that feels so good to say that. And I know like I've had cars before and stuff like that, but it's different when you buy your own stuff and when somebody's buying you something. I will tell you that it's definitely different. And yeah, it just feels really good. But anyway, that's pretty much it for the video. I hope you guys have an amazing week, and I will see you guys on the next one tomorrow, basically. Bye.
Oh my goodness, you guys. Okay, so look at this. I love this. I wanted these poles and stuff in the cabinets, which is there. Also, this is the double door cabinet, and it also has the rollouts, which I'm really excited about that. This was actually just $250 for this, so I got it in both drawers. So here's a quick look at what the stairs are gonna look like. It's so pretty.